now, let us paint a painting. Here it is, right here on the canvas. First, we're gonna do the floor, yeah? We're just gonna make a nice flat floor for this painting. We got a little friendly bug here on the ground. And we're going to introduce a flat floor where soon we will have a chair. And let's use a little bit of yellow. Just a little bit, tiny bit of yellow for the floor. How about that? How about some yellow? Right here. Let's apply just a bit of yellow, not too much. Right there. Right on the floor. Right on the floor. It's a little bit of yellow. And now, let's just keep spreading it all over the floor. Let's paint the floor all over the floor with that nice, friendly yellow. We gave a little bit of light on that bog, on that friendly bog. And now let's paint next to the head. Just a little bit of paint next to the head, yes. Let's keep unifying the unification of the floor. Unifying a color with a slight shadow next to the black, which is already on the canvas. We will keep spreading this white color, white titanium color, in between the characters that we can already guess on our little scene, on our interior landscape. Let's just spread some of that white titanium color all over our scene. And here we will soon have a chair. So we will already make an inkling of what the chair will be. We're gonna keep spreading yellow, yes. And there's gonna be more chairs over here on this side. I'm just gonna keep spraying this white and yellow, a little bit of black, with a little bit of black, right next to our main character. And we're gonna spread all this color all through, all the way to the corner of our scene, right there. Yeah, we're just gonna keep on spreading this white titanium and this yellow all over the floor. We're just gonna keep spreading it all over the floor. A little bit here in the gap of the body of our main character. Yes, this ballerina will have some white titanium there. And we will keep on spreading the white all over the floor, right? Just like that. We'll now start coloring the walls. And we're gonna let the white get a little bit of the black, which is already on the walls. Yes. We're gonna let this color just combine a bit. And we're gonna make a wall right there, next to the crack. There's some arches, as we can see, right here in our landscape. We're gonna take some of the white from here and spread it on the wall, like such. And we're gonna just keep on spraying it, trying to cover the whole wall. And we're just gonna keep on spreading it, yes. We're gonna keep on spreading this color all over the wall, yeah. We're gonna make the wall with that white color, with that white titanium. And we'll continue coloring the floor with white titanium on top of a bit of orange, which was already there. A dry orange, which was already there. We're gonna put a little bit more of that white behind the character, and then we're gonna come back here and keep painting the wall, letting the white be a little bit combined with the black used to make the contours and the outlining of our main characters, of this interior scene in this salon where the scene is unfolding before our eyes, before our very eyes. We're gonna keep giving this place some ambiance, casually rubbing the oil white over the other colors. For the most, there's black used for contour, yes. And we'll keep on spreading this wonderful, wonderful oil colors on our canvas. And we'll go all the way to the ceiling, and then we're gonna move on down. We're gonna move on down. And we're gonna keep spreading it all over the floor, trying to flatten down all that white color for the floor. Yes. And to define the place where our characters are doing their activities and their actions, and painting between them are little shadows of characters. For the moment, they're shadows, and later on they will become characterinos. Indeed, indeed. The color spread all over this scene. We're gonna add some more titanium white in both corners, yes. There we go. We're gonna keep spreading these wonderful colors. The colors that are at the present time present in our scene are some yellow, some light yellow, as you can see, some kind of lemon yellow, as people would call it. And we also have black. We have a little bit of purple to define the main ballerina here, the dancer, yes. And the color that is most abundant in our composition is the color white. Together, both the black and the white will define the image of the composition that we have right here. And behind those colors, already dry, we have blue, some sky blue, which we made with cerulean blue. We all love that color. Cerulean blue, how we love that color. Don't we just love cerulean blue? And we keep on spreading it all over. Yes, let's keep spreading this white for the wall, getting some casual shadowing in thanks to the presence of the color black on our canvas. And here we go, still spreading the color on the ground. Yes, we need to cover most of the ground. We're gonna put some yellow on this side. We're gonna profit of the yellow that we have right there underneath our friendly bug, underneath the friendly bugaroo that we have there. Also a little bit stained with the light coming from the windows, from the large windows. We will keep on defining this character a little bit, giving him a little bit of shadow, of shadaloo, right there. We will spread a bit more of this black color on our characters, defining them, using the shadows, using the black that there is to transform it into a bit of gray for the chair underneath this character. We can barely even understand for the moment. It's such a undefined character, really. We're using shadows. We could probably start defining a woman here in the background and another one here dancing, a strange form that is dancing in the room, dancing around the room with the love for ballet, with the lab full ballet. And here we go. Here's our main character, our largest form there, dancing amongst the shadows and the light of this ballet scene. And it seems like we need to keep spreading the white, yes, all over the walls, all over the walls. We're gonna savagely just keep on spreading this color to define our interior scene. We will not add a ceiling, no roof for the moment. The room will not have a ceiling for the moment. We will now use some light for this character. Light bathing this character on the corner. And we will keep on spreading the wall all over, all around the character. Yes, this character is there, just waiting to be a bit more defined. Yes, and we will keep spreading the white of the wall, and we will define furthermore our ballerina dancing all around the room. Yes, all around the room. And she will be there, the largest form in our composition, next to the wall, amongst the arches of this room, which will be colored with light and shadow all over, with an inkling of the blue skies behind. Let's look at the blue skies above our scene while we keep on building a wall here behind a character sitting on a chair. And here we have a bit more of this floor, and the floor and a bit of shadowing. Why not a bit of shadow next to the ballerina? Yes, all around the room she is dancing, and we are going to take more white from this side of the canvas to furthermore define our scene. Just keep feeling the canvas and filling it with a bit more of white with this brush here. A very simple brush, as you can see. It's just a cheapo brush. Simple as they get, a flat little brush to define the scene. And we will keep adding white to the wall for light. This will give the scene some more light. And the other side of the scene needs more of that light. We will make this side more filled with light than the other one. We will simply take more white from this side of the scene and put it on the other side. We will keep filling it up like this, yes. Filling up the room. Filling up the room with colorful light, colorful light. And we will start using the colors behind the colors to give tonalities to the colors in front, to the main colors, the orange that is already present there, and the purple and the blue and the green will colorize every other color here, and we will give some more tonalities to the color that we are adding right here. So now we're at a stage where we can start defining a bit more all of our figurines that are walking through the scene, that are inhabiting this little bitty world. And we can keep giving the chair some light, some color. We can just spread it in, and just put all the color there. Light, volume, shadow, shadaloo, people. I don't even know what shadaloo means, but we're gonna put it in the painting, yes. And we are adding all this color to the painting. White for the most, with the very strong color of black there, constantly mixing with the other colors to give it some light, yes, some light. And here we are, here we have a defining colors, and we're gonna give a bit of light to the outside of the painting as well. We will spread some of the white out here, outside of the arches, the large windows that we have here. So we're gonna keep on spreading this colorinos right here. Let's get some more of that titanium blue, titanium white, and spread it in. Let's cover that old strange looking shoe on the background, which I once painted. And now let's make it white, and we will later on add more cerulean blue to make this a part of the sky, to turn these into a composition, a new composish. You got your composish right there, and then let's just spread. Let's give it a little spread. Let's put some white on that composish. There we go. The shoe is no longer visible. There is no longer a shoe on the scene. And we now have these wild looking lines all over the place. We have this composition there, just sitting there and being a part of the painting, a part of the wild looking skies which are now filled with lines, and we are quickly going through that brush of ours, which with the wild movements and hard rubbing on the canvas will be extinct at some point, but for the moment it's working really well. We're gonna keep adding more lines and more brushstrokes to the skies. And now we have a bunch of them, and we have an interesting tonality of a dark sky. We're gonna have a dark sky now. We will now add a dark sky to our background. And our background is there just being a bit dark, isn't it? Just there. It's no longer an ozone bluish type of sky. It's now a bit of a darker sky. It's a bit of a white and grey type of sky up there. In the illumination of the afternoon, in the illumination of a dark day, in a gloomy day, yes. All gloom, ulalum, there it is. Our dark skies with the inkling, the beginning of a cloud. And we have that there. We have that there on top of the blue. It always helps to paint the sky on top of the blue, yes. And here we go, here we have it. A large dark sky. And we will now bind it to the top of the wall of our composish. And we will now spread over the yellow, yes. Spread our gloomy sky over the yellow. And try to make this more of a fly brush. Just spread all that color over the blue. Yes, how wonderful. Right over the blue. And we will now do circles. Some circling in, because the brush strokes are nice, but also circling in, just making forms other than just brush strokes and just straight Manet brush strokes, like the painter Manet, who did very, very clear, straightforward brush strokes. He loved the look of a linear brush stroke. And he loved to make it show. He loved the brushstroke. He loved to put brushstrokes very visible on his compositions, on his flowers, on his rivers, filled with color and filled with brushstrokes. And here we're gonna add more brushstrokes, some wild looking brushstrokes all over the painting, all over the painting, yes. Let's keep on this tradition of the brushstroke for the whole painting, for the whole thing. And now we almost have a completely covered in fresh paint painting. We will now start carving in the details. We will now start adding more details with a finer, smaller brush. But first we need to finish the work with this small, but for me, rather large brush. Now let's add a bit more titanium white. The whole thing, as you can see, is now this gloomy ambiance of a painting. This gloomy painting, and it's all over. It's all over the painting. The gloom, the sweet light of day, afternoon, it is there. The sweet, soft light of day, covering the entire surface now of the painting. We will now arrive to a point where most of the canvas is filled with this gloomy light. Keep making our flying brush just fly right through, without any worrying of mixing the black and the white paint. They will be mixed to complete the gloomy feeling, the gloomy feeling of our painting. And there it is, almost 100% of this canvas is now covered in titanium white with some detail added by the black, the purple, and the yellow. And there they are. There they are. Now this square-looking canvas is covered in titanium white. And we are almost at the point where we can start filling in the details with a smaller brush. We have an inkling of red there. A little bit of red still on our canvas. Let's give it a go there with a bit more of titanium white. A bit more detail there. Without hesitation, we can just add it in. We can add it in there, and we can just spread it. Spread for more detail of our dancer there, the ballerina being, her body being defined by the light coming from the archway there. And it is now all painted on, and it's getting a lot of paint there, and it is now being defined. The light is now defining the characterinos there. The brushstrokes are still showing. We're gonna get all those wild looking brushstrokes there on the canvas. And it is there on this windy day, all covering almost the entirety of the canvas, all there with our oil colors. And now just a bit more for this side of the window. We're gonna fill this window with our white, titanium white, and a bit more detail. And now we can use the smaller brush. for some more details. There we go. Bit more. And let's switch. Let's make a switch of this little bitty brush to another brush, which will be a size 10/0. A little bit worn already, a bit worn really. It's a bit worn. But there we go, there we have it. And the chosen color for this part of the painting will be, yes, you guessed it, it'll be white. We'll start doing some detail with white. Put it right there on the face of one of our characters, on the forehead indeed. And now we will paint from there downwards, really. We will start doing some detail from here. And the outline contour of his face, the neck, the necky neck, the arms, the shoulders, the rather enormous shoulders, because mantises have gigantic shoulders, and this is a mantis, as you can see. We have one of the hands of the mantis, the other hand of the mantis, and we will have one of their large forearms here and the other one, and we will now have its face kind of looking down, and we will have one of its legs there. Suggest one of the legs and the other one there. And we will now paint the rest of the body with the color of white. We will first add in the light, the chest of the mantis, and the lower part of the body of this rather large insect. And now one of the companions of the mantis will be there, starting to put some light on that. On that companion of the mantis, and it will be wearing some sort of a toga. So the toga will be worn by this companion to the mantis religiosa. It's a mantis religiosa. And it'll be there, standing in the middle of a crystal square. So there we have one of the companions of the mantis religiosa. And we're gonna have the other one, symmetrical, right there, standing there, with his shoulders very well defined, right there, next to the mantis religiosa. And now we will paint a woman looking back at a man. She's walking by, she turns around and looks at him, and we will define the neck right there. Down goes this part. It's one of her arms. We will now define the back of this woman. One of her arms, the other arm, and her hand with a gesture, and part of her back, and her waist, and her hips right there. And she's taking a large step towards the interior of the room, and here are her thighs, and she is taking steps towards the interior of the room, and here she is, here's her leg, there we go, and there is her body, and there she is walking, and now we will define one of the side of the face of the man looking at the woman using the yellow and the black. He's turning around as she walks by, and he's turning around and looks at her very curiously, rather curiously, looks at her as he sits on a chair comfortably, and she is walking by. There is his knee, there is his shoe, and there we define another character of our little composition. And now we will use a color that has not been used very much so far. And before that, we're going to define a little bit this character here. Before we use black as well, we're going to put one of his eyes here and the other one here. We're going to put the shadows of his eyes around the eyes. We're going to define the face a bit, the arms, his thin body, his rather thin body. And we're going to define his arms. And our little friendly buggy will be here walking through. And the foot of the lady dancing, the lady danzarina there. And part of her body there and one of her arms stretched up to the heavens. And now the back of the man, yes. We're going to take some of the white from here and we're going to put it on the back of the man to symbolize the light that he's receiving on his back. There we go, there we go. And now we will proceed on to take the color of red. We will now add the color of red on the man's back. There we go. There is a bit of red. And we will now continue defining this man's body. Here we go, the back of the neck, the backy back of the necky neck, defined with the color of red. He turns to the lady as she walks on by and he is looking in her direction, curious about her, looking at her as she walks on by. To define the chest of the man, his belly. He's a thin man with a belly. And we are going to do the arm, the thin man's arm. And we define with the color of red, the thin man's arm. And then we go on to the back. And here we are with the man sitting in a chair as she walks by. And now we will define his hand sitting, resting on his knee. There we go, there's his hand and there's his knee. There's his foot. There are his pantaloons. And we will dress him with a shirt. He's wearing a shirt. And there are his pantaloons, the man's pantaloons. And his shoes. We are going to have his shoes there. There we go, defining the man's shoes. And now we are going to define the lady with the very same color. She is walking by. We have her legs there, walking through. We will change the shape of her shoes. And there she is. Her knees, her feet, and there she is, walking right through. And we can see her legs, we can see most of her body there, walking, taking a stroll, and she's going right through the room. And as she turns, as the man looks at her, she turns and looks at him. As he looks at her, she looks at him. She is there, and she turns and looks at the man as she walks by. She makes a rather frosty look at him. He is in a very tranquil mood, and she is in a very frosty mood. She looks at him with barely any expression at all. He is looking at her with curiosity, and she is looking at him with curiosity. They look at each other as she walks by. And she walks by, here's her other leg. Here's her foot. There she is walking through. And now we're going to define the men here. That's right. And he is sitting there, looking to the front. We are going to define his face. We are going to have his left eye, like such. And we are going to have his right eye, like such. And there is the beginning of his facial anatomy, the shadows of the nose, and the shadows of the eye beneath the eye, and the shadows of the nostrils, not yet the nostrils themselves, and the mouth, which will almost have a faint smile there with his thin lips. It's a thin-lipped man looking to the front with this prominent cheekbones. You have some redeeming qualities, your cheekbones. And there we go, one of his redeeming qualities, the cheekbones. And he is smiling, basically. We have some of the shadowing of the face, some of the shadowing of the head. Both sides of the head are displaying a shadow, a shadaloo. We don't know what shadaloo means, but this painting has it, whatever it is. And then we're going to keep on adding the red ruby lips of this man. There we go, he has red ruby lips. And his neck a bit more defined, the body also a bit more defined. Let's get some more red from there. And there we go. There, the body of the man who is staring at the front, his chest, his arms. Let's get more red color from there. And there we go. And here he is, and there we go, there is the man in the picture, the man in the window, the man in the center of the room, just there, standing, staring at the front. We have more definition of that character. And now let's get some more of that red, and put it on the mantis religiosa, beneath the head of the mantis. Let's define the neck of the mantis. Yes, there we go. Let's define the mantis a bit more. There we go. Let's define its claws, its strange looking claws. There we go. There we go, it's odd looking claws. And now let's put that there. And now let's define the shadows of the body a bit more. Let's use this moment to give a bit of color to the man here, on the side of the picture, looking to the front. And let's put some color on the side of our character to define this one a bit more. Let's take a bit of that and put it here. How about that? On the waistline of this dancerina. Of this dancerina right there. A bit of shadow underneath the left leg. And now let's define our friendly buggerino there. Now let's put more white here, define the landscape a bit more. Why not? Just a bit more, just a touch, yeah? a bit down there, you know, a bit down there. And now let's come to this side of the painting and add a bit of white, why not? Right there, and let's keep defining our scene. A bit of white, and let's keep up the definition of the scene. Let's keep adding painting, paint to the painting, painting to the canvas, and let's keep putting more of that paint there, the oil colors. And now let's give a bit of light to the buggy woggy there. There we go, it's got a bit more color, a bit more light. And let's go fetch some white and some black from the painting. Let's look for a spot with a bit of white, with a bit of black. Keep spreading it, keep spreading it, keep spreading it. Yes, here we go, is a bit of black. Yeah, why not, to define our buggy woogie. There we go, one side of it, center, the other side. And let's start working on the face of this buggy woggy and its little legs and its little monstrous legs, its little tiny little monsters of the buggy woggies, the terrifying buggy woggies. And let's keep defining everything. Let's take some black from here, from the chair, define a bit of a chair there, which you can hardly see because it's covered by my books. And let's put some more black on the buggy woggy. There we go, there we go. A bit of black on its back, on the gap between one wing and the other one. Let's get some more black from here, from wherever we can find it. And let's add it to the horrifying, grotesque body of the buggy woggy. The buggy woggies are so grotesque. There we go. Well, let's put them there, walking, crawling next to our ballerina and to our friend Olino here, who is just staring at the front. Let's get some more black from down here. And let's put it on the man's eyes. Putting it there. Start drawing the nostrils. Start painting in the nostrils. Shadows of the eyes, yes. Shadows of the head, yes. A bit more radical. Getting a bit more radicalino with all that. A bit more red and a bit more black. Let's paint those lips. A very much stronger color, yes. And let's add the shadow of the lower lip. There we go. Let's give more definition to this character. Keep shaping his head. Start adding the ears. I'm going to put some ears on this fine gentleman. And we're going to paint a bit more of the body of this man. And we're going to put some more shadowing in the face of this man. We're going to put some traits on the face of the man with no lesser a color than the color of black. Keep adding some more shadowinos there on the ears, on the side of the head, on the forehead. Keep defining this character. Let's keep painting, shall we? Right there. And for the moment, we have arrived to a point where we can take the white from up here and place it here to define the ballerina. That's what we needed that car there for, to do some definition lines on the hand and arm of the ballerina. Right there, right there. let's get some more of that and put it on the ballerina's hand and arm. Let's define this. Let's define all of this. Let's put it there, right there on the neck too, on the strong neck of the ballerina from the ballet. Let's give more of a body to this dancing figure. And now let's define a bit more the head of this character here, which should have a rather large head. It's going to have a rather large head. And we're going to put some lines across the head. Right there with the lines across the head. And we will make an orifice on the front of the face where the mouth would be. First it's a shadow with a bit more black. Now it's almost an orifice. Not yet, not yet. We need to add more black, yes. Find more black all over the painting. To place it there, and there we go. Now it looks like an orifice. There we go, and let's take some white from here, from the mantis, as we shadow it in. And let's keep defining the face of this character with a rather large face indeed. Let's put some fingers on this figurine. And let's make a bit more detail on this buggy woggy, this terrifying bug. On this terrifying bug. On this terrifying bug. And now the ballerina, the beautiful ballerina. Let's take black from the arm and transport it up to the ballerina's facial features. Let's start adding some facial features. And let's put some more bone structure to this skinny man. The skinny man. It's a skinny man. And our character here looking at the woman passing by. And let's get some more black to define the mantis religiosa, which is there. There we go. Its legs, finding as much as possible with all this fresh paint, freshly added paint. And now I'm adding a bit more of white where you can no longer see. Just very quickly, we'll add all this white down the corner of the canvas. There we go, that's it. Now let's take this white here and spread it this way. And let's put it there where we have less white. Let's add more white. And let's color it in. Yes, let's color it in with shadows. Shadows all over. Finding spots where there's need for more wall color. Whether black, whether white, whether the whatever color that we are lacking on our canvas.
Yes.
On this dancing scene, and we are here completing the very first stage of our painting, of our dancing scene. I hope you have enjoyed this. This is the foot of this character back here. I hope you have enjoyed this video. For the making of this painting, and we will conclude this way the first part of our painting of a friendly dancing scene.